Let's see, higher order functions and closures. Here we have two simple functions that we're all used to. We have adder and mult. They take a variable and the first one adds the variable to itself. The second one multiplies it by itself. We can call them with the function name, pass the value, and here we're going to print the output. So 5 plus 5 is 10, 5 times by 5, 25. So that's all straightforward, what we know. Now, what else can we do with these functions? Well, we can treat a function like a variable or an object. That's why it's called a first order function. So that's what that means. It means that we can use the function the same as we can another object. So for example, here we've got a list and we've put the two functions inside the list. And if we print the first element of the list, you can see we print that function. Doesn't really tell us much, but you can see that we can actually get the first element of the list, 0, which will be adder, and pass it 5, and it gives us the same answers as we did before. So this is interesting. We can now use functions in a different way than we're normally used to using them. So what else can we do? Well, we've called the functions, we put them in a list. How about creating a variable? So the variable equals the function, not the output of the function, but we're actually making a variable equal the function. So now x equals the function adder, and we can call x as if it was a function because it equals adder. And we can do this with y as well. So we're going to call the function as we did before. So now we've got the function we originally called as we used to from a list, and now as a variable. So let's just comment that out for 1 second. And now it's going to get a bit more interesting. Now we're going to put a function inside a function. So here we're calling adder, and we're putting it with passing the function adder to print result, and then print result, the f, which is the function, we're going to run that with the x, which is going to be 5. So we're passing 5 to this function. So what we're doing is we're calling the function print result. We're passing it a function called adder and mult. And when we get that function, we're calling it inside that. So we're not doing too much different, except for we're using a function inside another function. So that's an inner function. So a function inside another one is an inner function. So let's see if we can run that. You can see we've got the same result. So we've called adder and mult several times using different methods. So now we're starting to use a function inside another function, which is called an inner function. So final example we're going to show with this code is to reuse that list. And with that list, we're going to call a function called outer. And inside that function, we're going to call we've got the list, we have two functions, we had adder and mult. So first of all, we're going to do adder with 6, 7 and 8. So we're going to add 6 plus 6, 7 plus 7, 8 plus 8. And then in the for loop, the second time around, we're going to multiply them. So you can see the function that we're using in outer. So first time, we're going to add them. Second time, multiply. We run that. You can see 6, 7, 8 added together. 6, 7, 8 multiplied together. So you can see now, we are using the function like normal, but instead of passing variables and lists, now we're passing functions. So this is where we've moved from our first class function to our higher order function. So why might we use an inner function? What's different? Well, here we've got an example where we're going to call this outer function and we're going to pass it two numbers, 5 and 10, to a and b. We've also got c in our function, and inside we've created an inner function that's going to check our variables. So let's just run this, and then we can see we've got check variable and we've got the values of our variables inside. So what this is saying is that our inner function can access these variables inside this outer function. But if we try to call inner, let's call inner function, what we're going to do is we're going to get an error. So what we're saying here is this inner function is not accessible outside. So that could be useful. What we have now is we have this inner function that can only be used inside the function it's inside. And also, inside the function, the inner function can use the variables that have been declared in the outer function and that have been passed to the outer function. And they can remember them, so they can be accessed and remembered using this inner function. So this is the primary reason and benefits of this inner function. Let's look at another example. Here we've got an outer function called doMath, and we're going to pass it a variable. Now inside we've got another function called power. So we want to work out a number, the exponential of a number. So for example, 2 squared is 4, 2 cubed is 8, 2 to the power of 4 is 16. We can carry on 2 to 5, 32, etc. So we can work out to the power of. Now we can do it with more than one go, if you like. We can pass different values and work out different powers of. So let's do math with squared, do math with cubed, and do math with the power of. So if we print the square of 4 and the square of 5, the cube of 4 and cube of 5, and the exponential of 4 and 5 to the power of 4, we can run that, and you can see 4, 5, and 6 squared. Sorry, 4, 5 squared, 4, 5 cubed to the power of 3, and 4, 5 to the power of 4. So what we've got here is we are passing, okay, so we've got the variable square, and that equals do math to the power of 2. So when we call square, we pass it 4, it's calling square, which is calling math, and the exponential is known and accessed into the power, and it's remembered. So now the number we pass it, number 4, we've got to the power of 2, and here we've got 5 to the power of 2. That's squared. Now we do the same thing with cube, and cube is the exponential of 3. So it takes, like I say, a little get used to, but it's, we're not really doing something that we haven't done before. So this opens up a lot more possibilities. Now what you're seeing here is a closure, because our inner function is closed from the outside. So this is called encapsulation, this inner function. And the closure, we can see that the inner function power accesses and remembers the variables inside the outer function, doMath. So it has the scope of the variables in there. So this is closure. If you like that introduction to higher order functions, please click the like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. We'll move on from this introduction to the next stage, which is generators. So join us soon.